Hey guys, it's Clary. Welcome to part one of my Lens Studio Beginner to Pro tutorial series. In the next 10 minutes, you're going to learn how to create this cute beauty filter by downloading Lens Studio, knowing your way around it, adding some skin retouching and makeup, and of course some stickers to add final touches. When I started learning Lens Studio, there was no step-by-step tutorial. I had to spend 500 hours scouring the internet and feeling lost most of the time, which is why I created this tutorial series to make sure that you can save time and just focus on creating. First thing we're gonna do is download Lens Studio. Typing in download Lens Studio on Chrome, and then we're gonna jump on this link. So just click this checkbox and hit download. It's usually best practice to download a version before the latest one, just because we know it's stable. But for this tutorial, let's just stick to the latest one just to make things easier. Essentially, you just want to install it onto your computer. When you open Lens Studio, the launcher will pop up, and you can see here that you can choose between starting with a template or you can start a new project. I'm gonna start with a new project. All right, so this is the interface. It looks a little overwhelming, but let me make it easy for you. Think of creating a filter like making a dress. The materials you need, like your fabrics and your sequins, live under resources, and the tools you need to put these materials together live under here. You put your dress together here under the objects panel, and the scene panel is a visual representation of what you're creating. The preview panel is the dress or your filter being shown on you. If you don't want to look at your face, you can click on multimedia here. I'm just going to switch back to my face since personally I find it easier to develop that way. Let's save our project. Now we are ready to get started. Start by adding retouching. Click this add button and then search up face retouch. Click on it, and you can see already that my face looks smoother. So you can actually adjust the amount of retouching by clicking on the object in the objects panel and then going to inspector. So think of the inspector panel as a way to edit any objects. It's on auto mode, but if you uncheck it, you can see that there's a bunch of options here. So I'm just gonna drag my preview panel out so I can see what's going on. So if I drag this all the way up, it gets smoother. Down, it gets rougher. So I'm just gonna keep it at 0.5 since I want it to look as natural as possible. Now that we've got the base ready, let's add some makeup. First, go to the assets library. If we go back to our dress analogy, the asset library is like a shop where you can get ready-made dresses and all you have to do is tweak it. Okay, so once you're in the assets library, type in makeup 3D. So this is the one you want. Click import and watch this side. So you know it's done when the assets show up on your resources panel. So just close that, and then you're gonna chuck this underneath the main camera like the instructions say, just like that. Don't worry about what cameras are yet. It is an important concept, but I'll explain it in another video. If you look at what we just dragged in, you can see that there's facial retouching, so we can disable the one that we did before. And then there's this head binding item, which has two ways to apply makeup to your face. Makeup with masks and makeup with textures. Let's start with masks. You can see here that this item contains something called a mesh and a material. So what are these two? To put it simply, the material is the colors that you see, and the mesh is like a plain mask and the shape of your face that you apply these colors to. This head binding tool here is what sticks the mask to your face. So if you click on makeup with masks over here on the left, and then you can right click on the material and click select, and that will take you to the material settings. You can see here in the material, you can change the color of the makeup. I'm not loving this orange tone on my skin, so I'm gonna go with a nice purple. And I can also change the alpha here, which is basically the opacity, to make it a little more subtle. So you can spend your time playing around with this, but for now, I'm just gonna choose some random colors and change it up later. So just to explain how this works, you've got this opacity texture which acts like a mask. Essentially, you're just changing the color of that mask here. All right, cool. But what if I want to change the shape of the eyeshadow? To do this, you need to edit the mask. I can right click, hit highlight, and that will show where it lives on the resources panel. So I can right click and view this in Finder, and then I can just go right click and open with Photoshop or your favorite image editing software. So these white parts are going to be where the color goes and the black parts are going to be transparent. I'm going to hit the symmetry icon over here, so that way I can just edit one side and have it happen to the other side. Edit both sides. When I'm done with it, just go File, Export As, JPEG, call it Shadows 1, 2. So now if I go back to Lens Studio, I can drag and drop it into my resources panel. So then if I go back to my material, I can actually drag and drop this into my eyeshadow. So essentially replace the mask with the one I just edited. And you can tell already the shape is a lot nicer and fits my face better. You can do that for any of the masks here. So for this tutorial, I've already prepared a couple of masks for you to use. You can download it from the resources folder in the description below. All right, so this is the resources folder. I'm gonna drag and drop Claire Create Shadows 1 and Shadows 2 in, just like that. Put Shadows 1 in Shadows 1 and Shadows 2 in Shadows 2. And then you can also replace the color and the opacity. I've got the values ready. They'll be available in the resources folder too. It's gonna get rid of this blush since we'll do it in the second method. And also, I'm gonna ramp up these eyelashes just to make them nice and long. All right, moving on to the second method. We're gonna apply makeup through textures. The concept is similar. Let's enable makeup with textures. Look at it on the inspector. All right, so you can see straight away that you can't change the colors here. And the reason being is because the colors is coming straight from the texture. So for example, for this blush texture, I'm gonna highlight it in the resources and then show in Finder and then open with Photoshop. Now that we've got it on Photoshop, it's clear that whatever texture you use is what you get. So the key to this method is to get the colors right in the first place. But how do we know where to paint? There's actually a little trick for this. Jump back on your browser and search up Lens Studio Face Mesh Template. Click on the first link and then scroll all the way down until you see this. This is called the Face Mesh UV. Copy this, go back to Photoshop, paste it, resize it to fit. And as you can see here, the blush sits right on the cheek. So the trick is, whether you go for the mask or the texture method, you need this face mesh reference to make sure that you're placing the masks or the colors in the right place. So when Lens Studio places your colors on top of the face mesh, it will perfectly map to the right places on your face. In this tutorial, I won't go over how to create individual makeup assets, but I have pre-made assets for you so you can just get started quickly. Grab all the remaining assets and then drop it into your textures folder. So now if you go back to makeup with textures, I can go into the makeup texture setup material. So first of all, I want to just get rid of the lips here. And since we've already got eyeshadow, let's get rid of that too. Also get rid of the mouth mask. And for the blush, I'm going to replace it with my new texture. So I believe it's this one. Then turn it up a little bit so you can see it. I'm also going to replace the eyeliner texture. Drop it in. So now you can see I've got a nice wing liner that complements my eye shade better. Okay, so what if you want to add more decorations? Like for example, freckles on the cheek or maybe some stickers. Go back to Photoshop. I just arranged my stickers on my mask. I got my stickers from pixart.com, but you can get it from anywhere. You can get free PNGs. Export this out as a PNG. Go back to Lens Studio, press this plus icon and look up face mesh. Click and drag it under the camera like that, and your face mesh should appear. To add the stickers we just created is pretty easy. Duplicate this face mesh and just make the first one invisible, and then I'm gonna rename this to stickers so we can keep track of everything. After that, go to the face mesh default material duplicate it, and I'm gonna name this one stickers again so we can keep track. So if you go here, you can see that the materials changed names too. We're gonna replace it with Claire Create Stickers, like so. You can even play with the metallic and roughness. It makes the stickers look a bit more shiny. I'm gonna add a bit of roughness there, just like that. Look how cute that looks, hell yeah. And then if you want to add even more decorations, you can just keep duplicating this object. So duplicate that. I want to add two freckle textures, so let's do it twice. And then I need to duplicate this too. Okay, I'm gonna speed it up from here because I'm pretty sure you get the point. Just to recap, we're duplicating the object and the objects panel and also the material attached to it, then placing the duplicated material in the duplicated object, and after that, selecting the new material and replacing the texture with the one from the resources folder. The last thing I want to do is add a natural shine to my face. Replace this material with the default material. So I think it was called base. And then I'm gonna rename it to shine. And then go select. And I'm gonna change the space color to black. Like so. Change the blend mode to add so you get this shiny looking texture. Get rid of these and then play around with the metallic and roughness like that until you get a natural shine that you want. So that looks really, really intense and we don't want that, so let's just bring down the opacity until we get something that looks a lot more natural. I'm not loving how glossy the lips are, so I'm just gonna turn down the gloss. There we go. That is so much better. Maybe just a little more. Okay, cool. And when you're done, click on the send to Snapchat button, open your Snapchat app and wait for the notification to come through. Tap on the notification and your lens should show up. Keep in mind that this is not published yet. It's just for you to test. I'll be making a lot more tutorials, so make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss out. Let's keep making cool shit. See you next time.